Hi, folks. Welcome to SEC Live News. I'm Pete Cordelli. What a great weekend it was for the SEC with the NFL draft. It started out with the number one overall selection of Matthew Stafford by the Detroit Lions. That was done on Friday night as his agent and the Lions got together and they agreed on a $78 million contract for Matthew, $42 million that's guaranteed. The SEC had 8 first-round selections on Saturday. That was one quarter of the draft on that day of the first round. It doesn't get much better than that. And then they had 2 selections in the second round. So on Saturday, the SEC ends up with 10 players selected, but 8 in the first round. That's a strong statement for the coaching and the playing ability of these young men in the Southeastern Conference. And then on Sunday, what a finish. 27 players selected from rounds 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And wouldn't you know it, Mr. Irrelevant, the last choice in the draft, number 256, he came from the SEC as well. Ryan Succop, the kicker from South Carolina, becomes Mr. Irrelevant. So the SEC, they have Mr. Relevant, the number one overall selection in the draft, in Matthew Stafford, and Mr. Irrelevant, number 256, the last selection in the draft. The SEC, with 37 total players drafted, had more than any other conference in the country, and this makes 10 out of the last 12 years that the SEC has either tied or been the leading conference in the country. The ACC had 33 selections. They were second. The Pac-10 was third with 32. The Big 12 and the Big 10, they tied with 28 selections each. And the Big East had 27 selections. Folks, this is another reason why the Southeastern Conference is king when it comes to football. There isn't a better conference out there than the Southeastern Conference. And it came through again this past weekend with the NFL draft. When you break down the NFL draft by school, South Carolina led all the SEC schools with 7 players drafted. And like we said, the last player, Mr. Irrelevant, Ryan Succop, the kicker, going to Kansas City. Georgia and LSU were tied with 6 players each. But Georgia, they have 2 first-round selections. And, of course, Matthew Stafford, the number one overall selection for the NFL draft, going to Detroit and going to be the quarterback for new coach Jim Schwartz. The other second-round selection was Knowshon Moreno. He was selected with the 12th pick in the first round by the Denver Broncos. New coach Josh McDaniel, he kind of sends a message that says, hey, the Broncos are going to rely on the running game. We need a guy as tough, as versatile, as agile as Knowshon Moreno, who can also catch the ball coming out of the backfield. So Georgia with 6 selections, but 2 of those in the first round as well. LSU, they also have 6 players selected, and one of those was selected in the first round with the 3rd pick by Kansas City. Tyson Jackson, the fine defensive end, goes to Kansas City. Now, this is the 2nd year in a row that the Kansas City Chiefs have used their first round selection on a player from LSU. Last year, Glenn Dorsey, the fine defensive tackle, was selected by the Chiefs with their first selection. Now Tyson Jackson, you know who he played with, is going to be on the outside with Glenn giving help on the inside to try to bolster that Kansas City defense. Ole Miss and Alabama, they both had 4 selections in this draft, but what a day it was for the Ole Miss Rebels. They have 2 players selected in the first round, back to back. Michael Orr, the big All-American offensive tackle, is selected with the 23rd pick by the Baltimore Ravens. And then at number 24, Parade Jerry, the fine defensive tackle, goes to the Atlanta Falcons. It's the first time in Ole Miss history that they've ever had 2 players go in the first round. Michael Orr had a fantastic senior year and a great Senior Bowl. So now he will go to the Baltimore Ravens and try to bolster that offensive line for general manager Ozzie Newsome, a former great at Alabama who knows the quality of SEC players. And then Parade Jerry goes to the Atlanta Falcons. Alabama also had 4 players selected in the first round, and one of those was a first-round selection, that being Andre Smith, the big tackle, going to the Cincinnati Bengals with the sixth pick in the first round. You know, some folks thought that Andre not going to the combine in shape, leaving the combine early, that would hurt him. He was also suspended for the Sugar Bowl by Coach Nick Saban. You know what was interesting? Nick Saban had a great, great recommendation for Andre Smith when he said, Andre Smith has played a lot of great football for Alabama. He said it's a shame that he got some bad advice late in the football season, but Andre Smith is going to be one heck of an NFL player. I thought that was a heck of a statement for Coach Saban to make about Andre Smith. And you know, the tape doesn't lie. Andre Smith had a great career at Alabama. Then the Florida Gators and the Auburn Tigers. They both had three guys selected in the NFL draft. But Florida, they have a number one selection as well. Percy Harvin goes at number 22 to the Minnesota Vikings. You know, on turf in Minnesota, Percy Harvin is going to thrill those folks up there. And I know Brad Childress, the day before the draft, the head coach of the Minnesota Vikings, made a special trip down to Gainesville to spend some time with Percy Harvin to see if he would fit in to what Childress likes to do with all the movement with his receivers and trying to create one-on-one matchups. Percy Harvin is going to be an explosive player in the dome for the Minnesota Vikings. The Auburn Tigers, like I said, they have three players selected. The Tennessee Volunteers had one player selected. That's unusual for the Vols. But Robert Ayers was taken in the first round with the 18th pick by the Denver Broncos. So Denver, with two first-round picks, they take two players from the SEC. Knowshon Moreno at number 12 from Georgia, and then Robert Ayers at number 18 to try to bolster a Denver defense that gave up way too many points for this to be a championship team. Arkansas, they also had one player, Jonathan Leaves, the fine center. He was selected. Vanderbilt had one taken, Kentucky with one. And then the only school that didn't have a player selected in this year's draft was Mississippi State. But Coach Dan Mullen is bringing a lot of excitement to Starkville, and he looks forward to changing that in the future. Folks, 37 players from the Southeastern Conference taken in the NFL draft, more than any other conference in the country. What that means is a lot of money for a lot of these young men. Eight first-round selections, that's one quarter of the first round. That translates into a lot of dollars for these young men. Matthew Stafford with a $78 million contract if he meets all the incentives, but $42 million of it is guaranteed. There were two players from the SEC taken in the second round, eight players from the SEC taken in the third, four players from the SEC taken in the fourth, six players taken in the fifth, two taken in the sixth, and seven players from the SEC taken in the seventh. So when you add that up to the eight taken in the first, 37 players. Again, what a great statement that is for the Southeastern Conference, the best football conference in America, bar none. And watch these young men make a contribution next year for their NFL teams. Now that you've heard my thoughts on the NFL draft, I'd like to hear yours. Is Cornelius Ingram going to really make a big impact with the Philadelphia Eagles, because the Eagles didn't need a tight end? How about Ricky Jean-Francois? You know, he's going in the seventh round of the San Francisco 49ers. Is he a steal for the 49ers? Because he was an impact player, even though he wasn't on the field very long. Or is it Lewis Murphy, the great wide receiver from Florida, joining the Oakland Raiders? And we all know how Al Davis loves speed, speed, and more speed. And you know, Mr. Davis, he wants to get back to the Raiders. Bombs away out there. And now with Murphy coming to the Raiders, that increases their speed to stretch the field vertically. Who, in your estimation, is going to be the guy that's going to have the biggest impact on an NFL team that was selected in this draft over the weekend? I'd like to hear from you here at SEC Live News. This is Pete Cordelli saying, stay tuned, because next week, we're going to do a recap on all of the SEC spring games, because now we know what players went to the draft, what players performed well, who didn't perform so well, some injury situations, some academic issues, and then with the incoming freshmen, we're going to give you an update on all 12 SEC teams as we review all 12 of the SEC spring games next week right here on SEC Live News.